multi-syllabic rhyme schemes. You've heard them from the greatest MCs throughout history, like Kool G Rap, Rakim, Big Daddy Kane, up to new guys like J. Cole, Joyner Lucas, Eminem, Tech N9ne, MF Doom. Lots of them. If you follow my Bars and Board series on this channel, then you've seen my take on multi-syllabic rhyme schemes many times over. So this is a breakdown of one of the techniques I use to achieve multi-syllabic rhyme schemes. It's a technique that I call word clouding. Now, this is by no means the only technique that you can use to achieve multi-syllabic rhyme schemes, but this is a technique that I like to use to get started, particularly if I'm not doing a narrative rap. If I'm just rhyming or using it as an exercise to write rhymes, or maybe for bars and boards where the concept is a little more abstract, then I'll use this technique to kind of get started. Okay, so the goal in word clouding is to get a nice substantive list of rhyming words and phrases. You're not actually writing bars yet, you're just gathering your material. So I think about this part kind of like a puzzle. The first thing that you're gonna do is scatter all of the pieces onto the table. And it's the same thing here. So we're gonna start with the phrase, and it could be anything. Today I've chosen bars and boards. Shameless plug, I drop bars and boards videos to this channel every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, so definitely check that out. Okay, now remember, this is for multi-syllabic rhymes, so we're not just looking for a word that rhymes with boards. We're looking for words that rhyme with bars and boards, all three syllables, especially the first and the third, are at ords. Okay, so off the top of my head, I got a few that come to mind. We've got carnivore, harpsichord, art of war, which makes me think of Star Wars, or Start the War. Now, Star Wars is missing the middle syllable, so we can either use that to break up the rhythm of the rap that we end up writing from this, or we could force a syllable in there because, you know, our whole thing is about bending words and rhythms to our will to make them work for our purposes. I also want to point out that for people who are interested in becoming good freestylers, this is an exercise that you should do daily. Whether you're writing or not, having a deep vocabulary of rhyme references is going to allow you to dig in deep when you're going off the top of the head. Like, off the top of the head, I be rocking the lead, but not the Glock instead. It's the Rock'em Sock'em Robotics I bred. Alright, so I'm just going to fast forward through this process of jotting down some more rhymes to create our first word cloud. Alright, here we go. Okay, so let's jump back in. All right, so I've got a pretty good list of some words in my word cloud, all of which rhyme. So let's just go through it. So we got bars and boards, carnivore, harpsichord, art of war, Star Wars, start the war, obvious connection here. Now see what I'm about to do as we go through this is start to draw connections between these words, because when we're rapping, rhymes aren't the only thing that can connect the word, and stream of consciousness sometimes isn't the only thing that can connect a word, but there's a lot of different ways to connect words. So finding the connective tissue means kind of going beyond the obvious sometimes. For example, words can be connected by an emotion that they present that's similar, or they can be connected through an idiom that uses those words or flipping those words around. I have a bars and boards I did called fist clap, and fist clap itself is an example of that. You know, Fist and clap are both actions that happen. They're related to the hand, you know. A clap is an action you do with the hand, which is fairly active and maybe even potentially violent. A fist definitely connotates violence. So fist clap isn't an actual thing. It's not a thing that exists. It's not something you can do. But it conjures up that kind of idea. So even if you don't recognize it in the moment, you understand on some subconscious or emotional level that those words are connected. So finding connections like that is really an important part of this process. Continuing, Martin Scorsese. Then I put Swayze in parentheses because Sazy and Swayze are really good rhymes. And Patrick Swayze is an actor. Martin Scorsese is a director. So there's an obvious cinematic connection there. Arson pours, and of course, we were thinking about what an arson would pour, like some sort of gasoline or fuel, something combustible. So that's good. Armored door or armored fort. I prefer door because it fits with the rhyme scheme a little bit better. Armored fort works, but it has a harder ending. So sharper, and then a blank, because that's another part of this word clouding. You don't have to have everything 100% lined up, and finding things that are close but might be derivative or kind of variate a little bit is actually a really good thing to have, because that's going to make for more interesting rhythmic patterns when you do put it together. Marksman scores. This is obviously connected to sharper. A marksman might be an archer. And there's another one right there. Just by talking through it. I don't think I had that one down. Okay, so marksman scores, archer, great. Stars galore, that's going to be connected to our Star Wars / start the war. Fart and snore, probably won't get used, but in the interest of being thorough, I had to write it down because I thought of it, and it's hilarious. Charmed, I'm sure. That's good because that's an old school idiom. It's not the kind of thing you would expect to hear in a rap. So I like putting that stuff in. Hardcore, bargained for. That's another great idiom that would be good to use. Lark Voorhees. Now, this is a little off the beaten path, but Lark Voorhees played Lisa Turtle on Saved by the Bell. And we've got the R sound in Lark, and we've got the Vor. We're missing the middle syllable. And he's is something we could use to make a double meaning for he's a jolly good fellow or he's on one. Anything that would you use this version of he's, we can make a double meaning out of and say something dope with that. And we can always figure out something to do with that middle syllable. It's the least important one, so we can throw anything in there, really. Target stores. Obvious hordes, and I'm thinking about Black Friday, hordes of shoppers at Target stores, and then I thought of charging for the door, and we got the charging for, and then the door is just another, it's a continuation, so it doesn't exactly fit the rhyme scheme, but that actually makes it better, it's stronger that way. So we can put that at the end of the line, and we get the bar, and then go one step past it, and that creates some unexpected rhythm, and anytime you can add the element of surprise or give people something beyond what they were expecting to hear, it's going to make everything that much more exciting. All right, then we got cart before the horse, which is a great idiom. And the cart before satisfies the rhyme. The horse goes a step beyond it. That's a good thing, because if you can hit that rhyme and then give them a little extra at the end that they don't see coming, then that's going to make your bars hit even harder. Starboard oar, which is great because starboard is a reference to boats. One side of the boat is called starboard. The other side is called port. And an oar is what you use to propel a boat in the water by hand. So that's great, even though I think starboard and port are referencing larger boats. I don't know. Somebody who knows a lot about boats can tell me if what I'm thinking is right. Then we got spark and roar, which could be a great way to connect arson pours, the fuel, you know, the combustive part. Then we got jargon and pardon, which are individual words that don't satisfy the entire rhyme scheme. They satisfy the first two-thirds, bars and jargon, pardon, bars and boards. So we don't have the or sound at the end, but that's okay because we can use these to tie other things together. And then we got par for course, which is another great idiom. And like I said, you can't overuse idioms. So now that we've got our word cloud laid out, let's go ahead and start stringing this together. So starting it for me is usually the hardest part of the process. And so I find that it's best to start from a simple place and maybe kind of stating the obvious or saying something that's truthful or kind of coming out the gate saying what it is the whole verse is intended to be about. So you just kind of make a promise at the beginning. So I'm just going to say, I got bars and boards. Excuse me. Okay. Straightforward. I got bars and boards. Okay, now I want to go for this harpsichord reference. They might... string you up like harpsichords. All right, nothing too exciting yet. How about... they go hard, of course. Of course, bars go hard. Okay. How about until we meet? And meet is going to be a double meaning. Meet as in get acquainted, but also as in flesh. Until we meet, and that'll give us a chance to use our next word, carnivores. Good. Let's say... carcass hardens upon the harvest floor. Now, I like this because harvest, you know, when I think of harvest, I'm usually thinking fruits and veggies. So I want to take that to another place deliberately. And since we're talking about meat, then this is a good opportunity to kind of cast a darker light on the whole thing and kind of paint maybe a kind of a morbid picture here. They go hard, of course, until we meet like carnivores. Carcass hardens upon the harvest floor. That's a bar. I actually like that. I got bars and boards. They might string you up like harpsichord. They go hard, of course, until we meet like carnivores. Carcass hardens upon the harvest floor. I'm not too worried about the rhythm just yet. Just trying to lay this out and we can tidy it up later. All right, let's see here. Okay, even to beg a pardon is far more than you bargained for. So taking advantage of the word beg and to be in a position where you're begging, you know, is not a position of wealth, not a position of advantage. So saying even to beg a pardon is far more than you bargained for. So this is classic hip hop hyperbole, but with a twist. Kind of like a literary twist because we're not actually dealing with any real materials. That's the beauty of this. When you have a word cloud, you can just kind of explore words. You can just kind of explore the bars from a real pure place without necessarily needing to say anything. One of my favorite things about these bards is the opportunity to let the syllables kind of exist in the place of music. My training is as a classical pianist and jazz, and so I always try to distill each individual syllable to the level that a note would play if I was improvising on the piano, and just let it kind of exist in the moment on its own. And I think that you can actually get to deeper truths that way than necessarily having to satisfy grammatical rules or, you know, standard language formats, syntax and all that. All right, let's wrap this up. We got one more bar. I got bars and bars. They might string you up like harpsichords. They go hard, of course, until we meet like carnivores. Carcass hardens upon the heart. Carcass hardening upon, let's just say, carcass hardening upon the hardwood harvest floor. See, I almost said hardwood floor. I could have gone that way too. I like this more. I got bars and boars. They might string you up like harpsichords. And they go hard, of course, until we meet like carnivores. Carcass hardening upon the harvest floor. Even to beg a pardon is far more than you've bargained for. So yeah, actually, when we do that rhythm, that's a full four bars. I got bars and boars. They might string you. Yeah, I got bars and boars. They might string you up like harpsichords. And they go hard, of course, until we meet like carnivores. Carcass hardening upon the harvest floor. Even to beg a pardon is far more than you've bargained for. So there we go. We got four solid bars. And we still have a whole lot of word clouding to get through. This could very easily turn into a full 16-bar verse. In fact, I might do that, flesh it out for my upcoming Bars and Boards video that I'll be posting soon. So that's it. Word clouding in a nutshell. I hope that you found it useful. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked it, please like, subscribe, and hit the bell button to make sure you get all the updates in real time. And follow on social media, all that good stuff. Stay in touch. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Peace. You don't need to have my back. I want my back to have the drive like that. Yeah, like this and like that.